Hey, what is up, you guys? Happy 4th of July, 2022. So you seen me shooting my bow a few seconds ago. I gotta make sure she's sighted in. It's been a while since I've put some arrows through her, but I gotta make sure she's shooting good for what we're gonna do today. Now, you've seen the title of the video, you've seen the thumbnail, and if you've seen last week's video, I told you as soon as these came in, we're gonna do a review. Well, they came in. These are the Tooth of the Arrow broadheads. So these old guys reached out to me a couple weeks ago and asked if I'd be interested in doing a review for their broadheads. I said, yeah, come on, bring it. I've done some reviews on my Mako, on my rifle scopes. CX3 Tactical has been awesome to work with, so I said, let's do this. Now, I'm not a huge review channel, so I take it as an honor. So while they were being delivered, I kind of did some research on them, wanting to know what I was getting myself into. And to be honest with you, I haven't really seen anything negative on these broadheads. Now, the broadheads that I chose to do the review on, I told them to send me, are the inch and 3/16 cut V series. Now, there's a V series and there's a S series. So we'll get to the different series here in a few seconds. I'm gonna give you kind of a rundown on their business, how they're made, customer service, all that good stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave some links in the description below on how you can get to Tooth of the Arrow broadhead. And also, guys, we're always looking for subscriptions. So if you watch the whole video and you like what you see, give us a thumbs up, subscribe. Also down in the description below, we're gonna leave some links to, if you wanna help support the channel, you can help us do that. If you wanna send something in for us to review, or maybe if I can get my hands on some of the stuff you want us to review, we'll do that as well. So anyway, enough talking, let's get on with the test. All right, guys, hey, before we get on to some of this testing, I wanna kinda give you some background and then some information on these broadheads. So Tooth of the Arrow has been pumping these things out pretty steady for the past 3 years. They've got over 25 years experience on their team with production, designing, and just making broadheads in general. Now, they are made from a solid piece of steel. So that's one of the best things I like about it, solid piece of steel. Now, all their broadheads are fixed four blade broadheads. You can get them from 1 inch to 1 3/16 inch, 100 grain up to 125 grain. All their blades are exactly 45 degrees from each other, and their blade thickness is 0.40. So they've got some meat to them. Now, the difference between the V series and the S series. I don't have the S series here with me, but the V series is just vented, is all it means, S being solid. Now, where the V series has an advantage over the S, it helps with crosswind, as most broadheads are probably designed for that. So again, they come from 1 inch to 1 3/16 inch cut, 100 grain to 125 grain. Again, I'll leave a link in the description below and you can go visit Tooth of the Arrow broadheads. What we're gonna do, I ordered the 100 grain, so we're gonna weigh a 100 grain field tip, see what that weighs in at for kind of a baseline, and I'm gonna weigh these three broadheads to see if they're weighing around the same. If they are different, I wanna see what the variance is in them. So let's go ahead and weigh some of these. First thing we're gonna do, we're gonna take one of our 100 grain field tips and we're gonna weigh it right here. Now, you guys probably can't tell, but the wind is horrible. Once again, it's blowing these things all around. I hope this field tip will stay on here. I'm gonna go ahead and set this, tear it out. Here is our scale. Now, I broke my other scale, I dropped it and broke it. It was the actual grain scale. This one's grams, but we can figure it out. We'll have a conversion chart. So right there, we've got 6.5. Wind blowing it around. You guys saw that. 6.5 is what it weighs. Now, if I take that over here to my conversion chart, 6.5, it's 100 grain. So we'll take our next broadhead. The wind's horrible. It's bouncing the scale all around. Here we go. Right at 6.5. So that one's 6.5. That one is 6.4. 6.4, okay. Remember that number, 6.4. And that one is 6.6. So we had 6.5, 6.4, and 6.6. So if we look at 6.4, that's 98 grains. And if we look at 6.6, that's 101 grains. So you have about from 100 grain down to 98 up to 101. So it's not that big of a variance, not that big of a deal. Now, I understand if you're shooting a bunch of long range, yeah, that will come into effect. But for 20 yards, what's what we're gonna test it on, we're gonna see what it's gonna do. I don't think that's enough to even really hurt anything. So that's a pretty good variance. I have some Rage and some Muzzy in there. Again, expensive broadheads, top of the line, right? I've had them be way different than that. So that's not a bad start right there. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna take these broadheads. I'll put this field tip back in. We'll do a spin test just so you can see that it's spinning true. This wind's horrible out here. You're gonna have to hold this. So just kind of zoom in right here and show them that it's spinning true. Spinning true. Nice. All right. I'm going to go ahead and put a broadhead in. Now, it comes with this little handy tool that most of you guys, if you have broadheads, I'm sure you've got a tool, but it comes with it, so we're going to use it. So just put it in there. Put in the arrow. And we're going to go ahead and spin test. So you can see right there, spinning great. I mean, nothing wrong with it at all. The point is just spot on. So I like that. That's number one. I'm pretty impressed so far. They're spinning good. They're weighing pretty good. Should have used that tool. I'm going to cut myself one of these days. That one's spinning real good as well. So far, so good. They're weighing good. They're spinning good. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I always like to take my, either my field tips, broadheads, anything, and run a couple spin tests just to make sure I can cull the bad ones right out of the box. So again, that one's spinning good. Nice and true. So they are perfectly balanced. So first couple tests, pretty good. Now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna shoot through the chrono a couple of arrows with field tips to get kind of a baseline. Then we're gonna shoot these broadheads through it to see if it changes any of the speed. Now it shouldn't because the weight are the same, but we're gonna see what it does. And then after that, we'll do some accuracy tests and then we're gonna shoot it through something pretty tough, see how tough these blades are. So let's get to that. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and shoot three arrows. Now I'm shooting my Matthews Verdicts, set up at 70 pounds, 29 and a half inch draw length. We'll be shooting these Black Eagle arrows, 100 grain field tip. We're gonna shoot three of them, see what those averages are. Bubba's actually gonna shoot his bow. He'll give you some explanation on that. And then we're gonna take the broadheads, put them on there and see if they average out the same, if they're higher or lower, and see how they do. So we're at 280 on the first one. Now, I'm such a dynamite shot, I'm liable to Robin Hood that arrow and it'll be caught live on TV. .281, it's not bad. Pretty good average there. And last one. .282, so we went 280, 281, and 282. Man, old bow's just getting faster. That's that Matthews Verdicts, baby. So I'm gonna let Bubba shoot his bow now. He'll give you the explanation on what that is, and we'll get that average. So 280, 281, 282, your average is probably around 281. We'll just go with that.
I'm gonna let old TJ go ahead and shoot through here, AKA Sniper, AKA Make Dad Look Bad Guy. So Bubba, what kind of bow are you shooting with?
I got the Missing Switch. 28 inch draw length, maxed out at 70 pounds. And we're gonna let some arrows fly today.
That's what I'm talking about. So we're gonna get a, see what his average is on his three arrows. Can't do this without letting a little guy get in there. Probably gonna make me look bad again. Okay, what we got?
248.
248, all right, there's your first arrow. This way now. What we got?
251.
251. All right, not bad. All right, one more. I had to let him wear my hat. He said he wasn't having a good hair day. Okay, so your lowest was 248 and 251 and 251. So let's say your average is around 250. Not bad, not bad. I had to give it my hat, so now I'm having a bad hair day. So my average was right around, what was it? think my average was around 281. His is 250. Again, both 70-pound bows. So now we're going to do the same thing with the broadheads and see if it slowed them down any. All right, so here we go. We're going to put our 100 grain inch and 3/16 V-series tooth of the arrow through the chrono and see speed comparison. If it slows down any, which I don't think it should because they're all pretty close. So, oh, look right there.
Good.
We got 279. I'll pull this one out. Yeah, it went plumb through. Look pretty good right there?
Yeah.
278. Look pretty good right there?
Yeah.
279. So we were averaging about 280, 281. I'll have to go back and look. We're shooting, we shot 279, 278, and 279. So just a couple of feet per second slower. Don't think it's gonna make a huge difference, especially around 20 yards or so. So anyway, I'll pull this one out. We'll get TJ set up and see what he does.
Am I good?
A little higher. Go ahead. What do you got? Okay, 250. Where are we at? 249. I don't know if y'all can see that very well or not. 249. Okay. These things are still shooting true with speed. They weighed what they're supposed to weigh. They're shooting about the same speed. They were perfectly balanced on the spinner. So now we're gonna go to accuracy test. We'll do three arrows and then we'll get to the penetration test. All right, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and take three arrows with just a field tip. We're gonna sling them down there, make sure we're getting a good grouping. And then we'll put the broadhead target down there and shoot these at the broadhead target and see how it compares. Go ahead, we're gonna shoot the broadhead now. I went ahead and put the broadhead target exactly at 20 yards. I moved the big fat target behind it just to kind of keep helping from moving around. Wind blowing like hell. I want kind of shoot with the wind so it didn't throw me off. So we'll shoot it. If it hits exactly where I want to, now the experience I've ever had with broadheads being off is they usually shoot low. So I'm gonna aim right at the top of that circle. If it hits where I want to, and if I feel comfortable, I'll go ahead and shoot the other dots. If not, we'll pull one out each at a time and see how far off they are. Right where I was aiming. So I'm gonna go ahead, I feel comfortable enough. Let's see if I don't screw this up on camera. I'm gonna go ahead and aim for the top right dot. I'm digging it. Top left dot now. It hit pretty much where I was aiming. The wind's horrible, but I aimed at the top right dot, hit it, top left dot, hit it, aiming right in the middle. The windage kind of got me with the wind blowing, but it didn't drop at all. So that's one good thing about these broadheads. You know, my bow is tuned for field tip. I haven't really messed with it on broadheads, but it's hitting where it needs to. So that's good for a regular guy right out of the box. Right now at 20 yards, you could buy these, put them on your bow or put them on your arrow, sit in the blind 20 yards away, and you're gonna hit exactly where you're aiming. So that's another plus for these broadheads. So now I'm gonna shoot through something that pretty thick, and I'm gonna see just how tough these are, and then we're gonna end the video. So I got some old pallets that I had that if you look right here, now this is this little soft wood on top, and then you've got you some half inch wood in the bottom. You got them in layers. But I've gotta watch where I'm shooting, because if I hit it right directly in the middle, I'm gonna be going through this 2x6 that's laid sideways, and I guarantee you ain't no arrow gonna go through that. So I need to make me a little aim point. We're gonna try to shoot through, be a total thickness of here, which is damn near an inch. Again, that's soft wood on top. That's just that little particle board covering this half inch boards. So, but I think at 20 yards, I'll tell you what, we'll do one at 10, and we'll do one at 20. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna shoot this right here at 10 yards. It's probably gonna wreck my arrow, wreck my broadhead, but we're gonna see what happens. So this is all for the name of science. So are you ready, TJ? Oh, well, I hit exactly where I was aiming and it buried it. Now, I'm gonna look through the backside. So, that pretty much buried it. Now, if it didn't make it through there at 10 yards, it's not gonna make it at 20, but we're gonna try it anyway just to see what happens. So, now I gotta see if I can even get this broadhead out, which I don't think I'm going to be able to. Look, don't look like it ruined my arrow, but I don't think we're gonna get that broadhead out. I need to get it out to see what it did to those blades. So we'll try to wiggle it a little bit with that. Well, that didn't work. So there's one arrow gone. Again, link in the description below to help out the channel if you want to help me get some more arrows. I appreciate that. I knew it was going to pack a punch when it hit. I figured it was going to destroy one of my arrows, but that's okay. We got more arrows to sling. So now we are 20 yards. And that's my 20 yard mark right here. I'm shooting the same place, just a little below. That's where that board's running. And we're gonna see what it does at 20 yards. See if it's about the same. Ooh. Ooh. It went a little bit further. I guess it had some speed building up. Yeah, it went further. Went about a quarter inch further. So if you guys, and it blew out the other side over here, you can't really tell, but it cracked this whole side. Right in here. This was a crack from the 10 yard. This is the crack from the 20 yard. Now, I don't think I'm gonna be able to get those out. Definitely not. Now, good thing is it didn't wreck this arrow and I'm not even gonna try. I'm gonna go ahead and pull this out. Save my arrow. Check that. Good, my arrow is good. I'm not gonna ruin another one. So, you can see the penetration, 10 yards. I guess it didn't have enough speed behind it yet. Maybe, you know, do the math, somebody gonna say, oh, you big dummy, 10 yards are gonna be stronger. Well, there's 20, there's 10. And again, this is almost, this is a little over an inch thick. Of course, it's got about a quarter particle board and half inch, a little over half an inch of regular pine. But I'm gonna tell you, that's a punch. I'm pretty impressed. Like I said, 20 yards, got a little bit deeper. The blades went all the way past. It's dug in under the pine. And the 10 yards here stuck flush even with the back of the blade. These are about a quarter inch deeper. So yeah, I'm pretty impressed. Let's get back there, put some of this stuff up, and we'll end this video. All right, y'all. Hey, so I had a blast doing this review. Tooth of the Arrow broadhead. I chose to do the review on the inch and 3/16 cut 100 grain V series. Again, they come in S series and V series. V being vented, S being solid from 1 inch to inch and 3/16 cut. They're aligned perfectly well. They're balanced very well. Set 45 degree angle, every one of them, for a perfect balanced spin on that arrow. 0.40 thickness on the blades. And this one here is still sharp as hell. Now this one only went through foam. It didn't go through the pallet that we shot through. But you guys seen they weighed what they were supposed to. Put them on the spin test. They were perfectly balanced. We put them through the chrono. They shot just spot on with the field tips. I think mine was about 1 foot to a foot and a per second slower. TJ's was spot on, didn't change at all. The accuracy test, they were shooting exactly where they were supposed to, wasn't dropping at all. And the, I guess you could say, torture test, shooting them through that pallet. It hit with, I mean, it thumped it. Now, granted, if I'd have used 125 grain with probably 75 pound bow, a little heavy arrow, probably wouldn't have went all the way through. I'm sure it would have done that. But this is the setup I like, the 70 pound. You know, I'll shot up the 90 pound. They're not hard to pull. They're just, when you do a lot of 3D shooting like we do, you know, you shoot 30 targets, kind of wear you out. So I use this as my 3D and my hunting bow. But anyway, Tooth of the Arrow, you guys kick some butt. Now I'm gonna pull those, I'm gonna try to pull those tips out if I can and show you a picture of what they look like. You know, what they look like after I pulled them out. Probably gonna be hell getting them out because they're stuck in there pretty good. Just again, if you'd like to donate to the channel, I'm gonna leave a link down below of how you can help us do that to support the channel. If there's anything you guys like to see us review, hey, hit me up. I'm gonna leave my email down there as well. Let me know on the email if there's something you'd like to see me review, or you can send something to me and I will give you my honest opinion and test it the best I can. So anyway, hey, Appreciate you guys. Appreciate all your support. Appreciate you sticking around watching this video. Have no idea what the next video is going to be on. Maybe we'll do some more fishing. Maybe we'll do some more rifle reviews. I don't know. We're just going to have to see. I'm going to do a hunting video with these broadheads, shooting some pigs and see how it acts. I mean, that's the ultimate review right there, right? You can shoot stuff all day long, but it needs to see what it does in an animal. So we're going to try to do that as quick as you can. But anyway, appreciate you guys. I'm going to let y'all get out of here. Just like every time we do this video, every chance you get, wet a line, let an arrow fly, put some rounds down range. We'll see y'all next time.